Hello everyone, I am your friend Shadab Imam and currently we are dealing with the topic of game theory. In today's lecture, we are going to see two-person zero-sum game without saddle point. So please watch this video till the end, and if you are new to the channel, please subscribe the channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon. So before moving on to the problem, one thing we must understand that in any game theory problem, our first step is to find out that if there is a saddle point or not. If there is no saddle point, then we try to minimize or reduce the matrix into 2 cross 2 size and then find out in which proportion each player is going to play their strategies, and this is called mixed strategies. Now let us move on to the problem. Here the problem says that in a game of matching coins, player A wins rupees 2 if there are 2 heads, wins nothing if there are 2 tails, and loses rupees 1 when there are 1 head and 1 tail. Determine the payoff matrix, best strategies for each player, and the value of game to A. So in this problem, first of all, we need to understand what is matching coins. See, there is a difference between tossing a coin and matching coin, or we can say game of matching coin. In a game of matching coin, a player intentionally has a coin in his hand and he can deliberately take his choice of heads or tails. Similar is the case for other player, and simultaneously both players shows their coin, and on the basis of their choices we got some output. First of all, let us make payoff matrix for this particular game. So payoff matrix for player A. Now consider, here is player A and this one is player B, and both have same choices, either it can be a head or tail. Same is with player B, it can be a head or tail. Now player A wins rupees 2 if there are 2 heads. That means if player A plays head and player B also plays head, then A wins rupees 2. So this will be plus 2 because A is winning amount. Similarly, it says that wins nothing if there are 2 tails. So if player A plays tails and player B also plays tails, then player A wins nothing. That means player A wins 0. And it says that there are and loses rupee 1 when there are 1 head and 1 tail. So there are 2 conditions for 1 head and 1 tail. One is when player A plays tails and player B plays heads, and the other is when player A plays heads and player B plays tails. In both the situation there is 1 head and 1 tail, and in that situation player A loses rupees 1. So this will be minus 1. Similarly, this will be minus 1. So we have prepared our payoff matrix. Now in any game or in any problem of game theory, first we need to identify if there is a saddle point or not. So let us quickly identify if there is a saddle point or not. So this will be rho min. So the minimum value will be minus 1. Here it is minus 1. And both are equal values. Similarly, we will calculate column max. And the maximum value here is 2. And the maximum value here is 0. So there are no same value in rho, column max and rho min column. So that's why we can say that no saddle point exists in this game. So what we need to further is to reduce the matrix into 2 cross 2 size, but this matrix has already been reduced, or we can say that this matrix is already in the form of 2 cross 2 matrix. So let us see what we need to do next. Now, as we know that there is no saddle point here, we need to calculate a term which is called oddments. Oddments. Now, how do we calculate the oddments? So for each row, what we need to do is we will take difference ignoring the sign. So we can see that 2 minus of minus 1 is 3. So the difference here is 3 of row 1, and we will write that difference in the opposite row. That means we will write it against row 2. So the oddment here is 2 minus of minus 1 is 3, and we will write 3 here. Similarly, we will take the difference of this 2, that means 0 minus of minus 1 is plus 1, so this is 1, and we will write this value against the opposite row. So this will be 1. Similar is the case we need to do with column also. We will take the difference of 2 and minus 1. 2 minus of minus 1 is plus 1, so this is 3, and we will write 3 into the opposite column, or we can say we will write this against opposite column. So there it is, 3, and the difference here is 1, and we will write it against opposite column, so this will be 1. So we have calculated the oddments here. Now we can see that player A plays head, and the probability of player A playing head is 1 divided by 1 plus 3. So this will be 1 divided by 1 plus 3, which is equivalent to 1 by 4. Similarly, the probability of player A playing tails, so probability of player A playing tails, it is 3 divided by 3 plus 1. So this is 3 divided by 3 plus 1, and this is equal to, and this is equivalent to 3 by 4. So similarly, we will find out the probability for player B also. The probability of player B playing head is given by PH, and this is 1 by 1 plus 3. So 1 by 1 plus 3 is 1 by 4, we have already seen here. And the probability of player B playing tails is 3 by 3 plus 1, that is 3 by 4. So this is 3 by 4. Now this shows that player A will play head 1 by 4 times, that means 25% of time, and player A will play tails 3 by 4 times, or we can say 75% of time. Similarly, player B will play head 1 by 4 times, that is 25% of time, and player B play tails 3 by 4 times, that is 75% of time. So we can see here, or the optimal strategies for player A, this can be written as head and tail, this will be 1 by 4 comma 3 by 4, or we can say that player A will play head 25% of time and tails 75% of time. Similarly, the optimal strategies for player B will play head 1 by 4 times, that is 25% of time, and player B will play tails 3/4 times, that is 75% of time. So these are the optimal strategies for player A and B. Now we need to find the value of game. So in mixed strategies, we will calculate the value of game by a very simple method. So let us see here, value of game for player A, or we can say A and B both, we will see it further. It is nothing but the multiplication of any row multiplied by their probability. So let us take the first row, that is 2 multiplied by 1/4 minus 1 multiplied by 3/4. So we'll do it, 2 into 1/4 plus minus 1, this is minus 1, multiply by 3/4. So, and this is equal to, this is minus 1/4. So minus 1/4 is the value of game. Now, if we calculate it with second row, or we can say first column or second column, the value of game will be same. Let us see here. If we take the second row, then minus 1 multiplied by 1/4 is minus 1/4. 0 multiplied by 3/4 is 0. So the value of game will be minus 1/4. And if we consider column, let us see if we consider first column. So this will be 2 multiplied by 1/4 plus minus of 1 multiplied by 3/4. So this will be the same equation, 2 multiplied by 1/4 plus minus 1 into 3/4. So the value of game will be minus 1/4. And if we consider the second column, this is minus 1 into 1/4, 0 into 3/4. So the value of game will be minus 1/4. So we have seen that the value of game will be same if we take row or column for our calculation. Now in this, we have find out the value of game for player A, and in this problem it is for player A and B both. Now we need to remember one thing, that if the oddment, or we can say the value of oddment for horizontal and vertical are equal, suppose this is 1 plus 3 4, this is also 1 plus 3 4, then the value of game will be same for both the players. That means this value, or we can say this value of game, is same for player A and player B both. So here the value of game for player A and B is minus 1/4. So I hope this is clear to you. If you like the lecture, please share the lecture. Have a nice day. Thank you.